So here we are sharing the WASH working group updates and Wateraid being the chair of the WASH working group. Next, please. In last October, officially Wateraid took the chairing role from UNICEF and tried to understand the ongoing and upcoming priorities and major agenda issues. Accordingly, we at Wateraid formed an internal support group so that we can take part in discussions with other subgroups and duly provide our support and inputs, and also can take back discussion issues on WASH from different platforms for further discussion. We are glad that a full-time WASH focal point joined at GTFCC, whom I think you all know, and that was a great support for us to coordinate for our working group, maintain liaison with GTFCC, work for specific WASH guidance and support activities for cholera control by partners. Still, we feel that WASH work plan need to be revisited with members of the working group, which actually we could not do in details with members for the pandemic. Next. So, on the activities, during the corona period, we could not really meet in person. So we planned our actions to limit online presence and remotely over some webinars as a means to sharing and learning. We organized two webinars, one in March and one in April. We provided technical support to identify indicators for hotspot methodology analysis. We took part in a session in the last World Health Assembly in May in a side event where our Wateraid CEO team and our Zambia Wateraid colleague presented and emphasized the need of WASH to eliminate or control cholera globally. We have still two more webinars as planned for July and September. The detailed information are available in the GTFCC website. Next, please. In the first webinar, where we focused on Zanzibar, Tanzania, we shared the experience of ZACCEP, Zanzibar Comprehensive Cholera Control, Cholera Elimination Plan, where almost 52 participants joined and presentations shared by the Ministry of Health and Zanzibar Water Authority. This presentation shared the challenge for multi-sectoral coordination and implementation, and also the resourcing issue. Next, please. In the second webinar on Zambia experience, we heard and listened from the speakers. They clearly highlighted a model case from Zambia where WASH integration and its impact presented, and where almost 65 participants joined. The presentations were made from Ministry of Health, Ministry of Water Development, Sanitation and Environmental Protection, and also from private side, Wateraid Zambia, Zambia Red Cross Society. And the insight and experience they shared, we saw that the substantial budget allocation has been made in, that was a great learning for us for further discussion. Next, please. So in the, we have two more webinars in plan. In the ensuing third webinar, we will focus on the research agenda, which has role in WASH for cholera control. We will try to capture the newer ventures, identify gaps, priorities, and potential research scope. And in the last webinar planned for September, we will focus on the technical issues to discuss on bottlenecks or potentials for WASH interventions, and also to strengthen the internal working group relationship. Next, please. So in the key achievements, we must say that even within the pandemic and remote working pattern, we have created the momentum across working groups and within the WASH working group as well. We have provided inputs for identification of indicators for hotspot analysis and methodology with the surveillance epidemiology work group. A piloting on minimum WASH package is on in Ethiopia. Newly planned country support platform, we plan to integrate with stronger WASH focus and discuss with CSP team members. Next, please. So we have some challenges too, and the most important is being the chair for WASH working group. We are quite new, and also our WASH focal point is new, but we certainly are moving forward gradually. We need to push further for WASH integration within and across other working groups, specifically with the surveillance and laboratory group on cholera detection and water quality monitoring, on case management, where scope for infection prevention or IPC and healthcare facility or cholera treating center, and importantly on the community engagement. Next, please. Among other challenges, we need to think for WASH specific guidance for national cholera control plan, development and implementation, monitoring indicator design and implement, data collection and follow up for analysis in hotspots and OCV campaigns as well, tracking progress against the global and national roadmaps, considering the SDG 6 as well. So we need to push and advocate for resource mobilization, capacity development, etc. Next, please. On the this year, 2021-22 priorities, on technical guidance, we need to finalize the indicators as already mentioned for hotspot methodology and WASH information within the OCV application request and during OCV campaigns. In research, we need to collaborate and promote GTFCC research agenda related with WASH issues and need to focus on priority research agenda. We will talk a little more in the research slide. In advocacy, we need to continue the ongoing advocacy with national governments and donors as well to prioritize WASH interventions. Representations in country and regional meetings and promote and support the hand hygiene for all programs for all countries. Next, please. So in the research section, as mentioned, we need to identify the coverage of WASH for hotspot control and cholera control program to identify the most essential or very basic IPC intervention for reduce risk transmission, then how to improve WASH access or in design thinking to develop the people's understanding. And finally, to sustainable investment plan and issues in WASH at country level. So next, please. Please see the list of members, which I'm not reading, but approximately 26 partners in the list. I pause for some time here so that you can just have a look on this list. And we are very thankful to each and every one of the members from this group for their contributions, support, and to uphold the WASH agenda within the cholera control elimination plan. Next, please. And finally, thank you for your patience and listening to our working group updates. Thank you very much.